The problem has always been, if you have 1,000, whatever, 2,000 people in one place, and then you're going to disperse them, do you have 2,000 other beds of equal quality, of equal care? And the answer to that question has always been no. So frankly, what the department should have done, if it was being honest from the beginning, is renegotiate the contract with Life Esidimeni if it was concerned that it was paying too much. Identify, and again we said this to them, patients who were less severely ill, who could perhaps have been moved back into communities with a greater degree of support, do a proper audit and work from that basis. Not, okay, we don't like this contract, it's costing us too much, we're going to end the contract. We're not worried, well, we say that we're worried about the patients, but our behavior shows that we're not really worried about the patients because it's just another thing that grows across our desk. You know, when we first raised this issue, we sent an email to the MEC, and then by mistake, the MEC replied, and then one of her officials, by mistake, sent her reply to us, by mistake.
What was it like that?
And in the reply was something like, don't trust these people, they're anti-government, there's no need to cooperate with them. As in us, as in Section 27. And from the beginning, you know, we raised that. I phoned the DG, I phoned the Minister of Health, I said, how do you expect us to work with a person like this? We're trying to raise a real issue here. Now we know what she thinks of us. She's not fit to be the MEC, and she should be held accountable for this. You know, I've heard the number 60. From more than one source.
And it's reliable sources?
From a reliable source. I'm not able to say where, but I have heard that number from more than one place. So I think it's plausible that it could be up to 60. It could be more than 60.
The department is not saying anything.
Yeah, but it's a lot of people. It's a lot of unnecessary death, and we have to get to the bottom of it. They may have died because they didn't have the medicines that they were used to, that they needed to control their illnesses, which may have caused behaviors that caused their death. In some instances, it seems as if they may have died simply out of the negligence of the care, not receiving enough food, not receiving the physical comfort that they needed, not being restrained, not being controlled. You know, our weakness, speaking for the families and Section 27, the Depression Anxiety Group, is that we weren't there. We have to go on what we're being told. This information is in the possession of the health department and it's in the possession of the NGOs. That's why we have to get to the bottom of this.